Hi folks, welcome back to the Horde. Let's see, it is 4:26. It's Saturday the 19th. That one says 79.3 degrees. This one says 77 degrees. That one says 24.4. And my batteries aren't fully charged. So what am I up to today? I really want to get the Speed Defies Gravity bike complete. As in clutch cable fixed, plastic on, that whole thing. And I spent some time messing with the clutch cable. This is the new clutch cable I bought. The one that actually fits better than the old clutch cable. The old clutch cable, the inside piece was too long. This piece is too long. So the adjusters here and down there are all the way out, and still the cable's a little bit loose. So when you pull on the cable to shift gears, it's not bad shifting gears once you're rolling, but kind of shifting it into first from neutral, she's a little clunky, and getting it into neutral is a little bit difficult because the clutch kind of doesn't fully disengage because the cable's too long, and that means you're not pulling this thing all the way up. I sought advice just to see if there was some trick out there that I didn't think of, and a couple of suggestions. One was opening this up and trying to take some of the play out. It seems like this is fairly well adjusted, so I don't think that's gonna help much. So after fooling around, given that I have the new cable, which is better than the old cable, and the old cable, which is fine, except that once again the inside is a little bit too long, I decided to check on some YouTube videos and did some research about shortening a cable up, and that's what I did. And just to show you guys what I'm up to, what I did was I cut about an inch off the cable. You guys could see that, and you guys could see I practiced on one side of the cable just to make sure I can do it before I started messing around with the cable itself. So I cut one end of the cable off. Some people would like to use these to cut the cable. Don't use a Dremel tool. Makes it so much easier. And I even wrapped, I don't know if you guys could see it, it's real fine wire, kind of wrapped that around there just to make sure it wouldn't unspool. It turns out it didn't unspool, so I was able to cut it off. And once I cut it off, you kind of, where's the rest of it? I got some copper pipe, right, this is just air conditioning tubing, I guess, and I drilled some holes in it just practicing to get the right size so that the cable fits tight. Then I cut a piece off, and I kind of just hacked a piece off, right, drilled a hole in it, hacked it off, cleaned it up. To clean up the inside of the pipe, and you have to clean up the inside of the pipe, I use this Dremel. With that, to clean up the inside of the pipe, to clean up the outside of the pipe, I just used typical emery paper. To cut the pipe, to cut the cable, I used this. To cut the pipe, it came out a lot better using a pipe cutter. So after I cut the pipe to the right size, and this one, once again, you can see I just hacked on it. It's not all that pretty. I spread the cable, kind of splayed it out so that I could get in there. Then I used carburetor cleaner to clean it. Then I wiped it with a clean rag. By clean rag, that's what you use the end of your shirt for. You see, clean rags, like the end of your shirt, are recycled regularly because you run them through the wash. So I cleaned it with carb cleaner. And then I wiped it, then I cleaned it with carb cleaner again, then I wiped it and cleaned it a third time with carb cleaner. I cleaned the piece of copper Obviously with the Dremel and carb cleaner and all that, I fluxed the hell out of all of it. Particularly once I slid it on, and I think you could see it a little better with the end of the cable here. Once I slid this new cable end on, my homemade cable end on, I slid it all the way down. I splayed these out again so that I could get a lot of flux in there, made sure I had a lot of flux. Then when I slid this back up, it squeezed everything back together again. I don't know, if you're also able to look in there, not only is the cable in there, but I jammed a couple of pieces of clean copper wire. Once again, I used the emery board to clean it up. And, you know, just some clean copper wire. Just jammed a couple of pieces in there. Once I got everything cleaned and fluxed and centered and pretty, what I did was I needed to heat up solder in a little solder pot. So I got a half inch plumbing cap there. You guys could see it. And I put some flux in there. Then I heated it up over the torch, right? I don't know, could you guys see that? I heated it up over the torch, and once it was all molten, you know, mixed the end of the solder in. By the way, the solder I used was 4060 lead tin. I did not use any of the new kind of solder. The lead-free solder, and this is the solder paste I used. This is typical Home Depot or Lowe's solder paste. So, and once again, 60-40 lead tin or tin lead. I used a little elbow, you know, heated it up. Then I dipped the end of it in. Right, I splayed this out a little bit so that wouldn't fall off. I dipped it in, and you could see, I think you guys could see, I got quite a bit of solder in it. I've been kind of pulling on it with my fingers and all, and it seems to be staying on there pretty good. So I think I got it. I think it's gonna stay there. So it turns out I decided to cut and re-end the cable. I mean, nothing surprising. Once again, use the Dremel to cut the cable. If you use something like this, you can make a real mess. So use the Dremel to cut the cable. Used tubing to make my ends. It's better to cut it with this. I used the drill press to drill the holes. And we'll take a walk up. I'll show you what size in a second. It looks, I mean, that's the old one. That one there is the old one. That's the new, the same size as the new cable end. Or to compare, right? I think I got, oh, there you go, right? I think I got them so that it'll work. The lead cable end also had that little bit of, I don't know, there you go, that little piece of plastic over it. I don't think I'm going to need the piece of plastic. I think the copper's a little bigger. So, when you could say, well, if you use just tubing, you're only holding it on both sides of the tubing. That's true. That's why I slipped those two pieces of wire in there and soldered them on also. From the people who made their YouTube videos on this, they claim that this, the solder pot technique, you know, dipping this right into the solder pot like that, works better. And the reason why it works better is if you use the torch, the whole thing actually gets too hot, then the solder won't stick. I don't know. I took their word for it, and the guy's video I watched actually used the end of a tire iron that was cut off. I could have done that, obviously, but why cut up a perfectly good tire iron when you could use a little piece of plumbing termination there, a you know, an end cap, so to speak, a copper end cap that worked just as well, and I didn't have to go cutting up tire irons. Also, the copper end cap, given that it's copper, it heats up really good, and I mean, it worked beautifully. Obviously, while you're doing this, it's wise to wear safety glasses, it's wise to use leather gloves, it's wise to not be quite working at face level. All these things are wise. You guys can see my garbage can workbench. My mother would be so proud if she could see me. All right, let me just show you the drill press, and obviously, depending on the size cable y'all are fooling with, that depends on the size hole you drill. If the hole's too small, obviously you're not getting the cable into it. If the hole's too big, I don't think the connection is as strong, because you would actually lose the solder. You know, having a huge area of solder holding it, I think it would just crack on the solder. Anyway, the size that I use looks like 3/32. So that's the size I used. Anyway, I'm still recovering from coming home from Alaska. It took me it's taken me a little longer to get back to normal sleep and work routines and everything else. I guess I don't know if they gas you on the airplane by not changing the air often enough or what the story is. Boy, we were on an A300, and I'm not a little guy, but I'm not a huge guy either. I'm, you know, about 5'8", somewhere around 200 pounds. I fluctuate between 190 and 200. When I got on the plane, I was about 200 pounds, 10 pounds up from the, I gotta shut this down or YouTube gets, you know, deletes my videos. Anyway, so at 200 pounds in that seat on that A200, it was so freaking tight. I mean, I've been flying long enough that I remember the days when, for an economy seat, you could be sitting at the window seat, and if you had to get out, you can kind of climb over the people next to you. Nowadays, you know, if you're trying to climb over the person next to you, the space is so tight, I don't even think there's enough room to do the dirty deed in there. I mean, you are just squeezed right up against, you know, when you're in your seat, you're squeezed up against the seat in front of you and against the seat back. I mean, it is just tight in there. Anyway, between that experience of flying back, I don't think they gave me good air, and then had to work 3 days this week. Not that they were hard. They were busy, 2 12s, and last night was a 4. But it seems that I'm enjoying my sleep a real lot. I guess maybe that's a good thing, to be able to sleep, but it doesn't lead to getting too much done. So hopefully I'll get myself back to an awake state and back to getting some crap done around here. Got most of the grass cut. I have to finish that up, and grass is starting to slow down, so be able to put it on in every other week cycle, which will be good, and working the shorter schedule will be good. Paycheck on the short schedule, boy, did they take some money away from me. They took away, they were supposed to take 30% of my paycheck, but because I lost overtime on the night shift, they actually took away more like 40% of my paycheck. So, you know, my paycheck's a lot smaller. Might have to start behaving a little better about buying too much crap. All right, folks, thanks for watching. Thanks for commenting. Thanks for subscribing. I'm going to put that cable on. We'll see if the whole thing works. Take care. Live long, live happy, and try to live carefree. Bye now.